Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be a block showcase video about a block or two from the Draconic Evolutions mod. I'm talking about the Player Detector and the Advanced Player Detector. So, there are several mods that add a similar functionality to this, but in my opinion, the Draconic Evolution one is by far one of the best out there, pretty much because of its configurability and its, well, yeah, loads of options that it offers you. So, let's get started. So, first of all, I will quickly start off with the recipe. The default player detector requires 4 pieces of iron, a redstone torch, 2 redstone comparators and an eye of ender, and a draconic core. And draconic cores are 4 ingots of gold, 4 draconium ingots and a diamond. And then the advanced player detector is 4 draconium ingots, a wither skull, 2 eyes of ender, a compass and one of the previous showed player detectors. So, player detectors come in a variety of ways, but they pretty much all serve the same goal. They emit a signal of some sort when a player is nearby. So, right here I set up myself a normal player detector, which I set to the maximum radius. And if I get within this border, you will see that this thing starts emitting a redstone signal of 15, which is pretty much the only amount this thing will output on its own. So, as you can see, right here, I marked the area off for the play detector, that is for its maximum range. But by right clicking this thing, you will be able to change its radius from being a 1 block all the way up to a 10 block radius. So, as you can see, if I set it to 2 blocks, it will only emit once I actually stand into one of these blocks. But if I step out of that, it won't. Do keep in mind that it will only work if it in actual straight lines, but it pretty much checks for a circle. So if I stand in this block, technically you could say it's still 2 blocks out, but it won't work because, well, the thing searches in a circle pretty much. So yeah, pretty much what you can do is just cycle through this by right clicking all the way up to a 10 by 10 field. But if I step out of this, you'll see it will stop emitting a redstone signal. Pretty basic, but again, it offers a lot of functionality. This thing would also work in directions as up, as you can see, and also down, but of course down is a little bit difficult to show you as I cannot put redstone upside down. Well, not the vanilla redstone that is. So yeah, pretty cool, but of course, for some people, just a basic player detector like this is not something you would want, because you may want something that only works on yourself, or does pretty much exactly the opposite thing, which emits a redstone signal when no one is around. So yeah, that's pretty cool, because for that we will need the advanced player detector. First of all, the first thing that you will pretty much notice is that this thing has a bigger radius. Instead of a 10 block radius, the advanced player detector offers 20 blocks in total. Pretty awesome. And instead of just right clicking through the options, this thing has an actual GUI. Pretty awesome already. So, as you can see, there are a couple of buttons. First of all is the range button, which, well, pretty much speaks for itself. Again, it allows you to configure the range on these blocks. And again, it searches for a circle, so both up and down will work. Pretty awesome. Yeah, cool. Then right here is a camouflage button, or, well, a slot pretty much, which allows you to put any type of block in it, pretty much like a full block, so don't try to put stuff with MBT data in it, because that won't be accepted. But stuff like hardened clay, for example, just put it in there, and the player detector will look like clay. And even for Wayla, as you can see on the in the top, it will actually show that it is hardened clay and not the player detector. So this is awesome if you want to hide something either in a floor, in a ceiling, in a wall, or pretty much wherever you want to. Pretty awesome. Then there is another pretty cool feature, which is both whitelisting and blacklisting. This thing will pretty much determine what players will trigger the play detector. Using this little exclamation mark, you will be able to switch between whitelist or blacklist. Whitelist pretty much meaning you put a name in this thing, which I currently set to my name, for example. And then that means that it will trigger on only these people added in this list. And white blacklist will mean it will work on all players except the ones that you actually specified in this block right here. Pretty awesome. So it works pretty simple. As you can see, you have 40 different slots right here. All you have to do is click one of these boxes to which one you want to add your name. Type in the name of the player and hit enter to save. As you can see, when I did that, it will automatically update and emit a redstone signal, which it should. Pretty cool. Then there is one final button down here, which is the invert output, which is what I talked about if in case you want to make a redstone signal when no one is around or when the specific player that you specified is not around. So what you can do is set it to true, and I do have to quickly update this because when switching modes, it seems to be kind of not automatically updating the redstone. So as you can see, I still have it whitelisted and set to me, but it is inverted. So that means that if I step out of this area, it will start emitting a redstone signal. But if I get inside, it will turn off. This can be very useful for, let's say, a force field, for example, that is powered on by redstone. Just, you know, if you are within the force field, let's say there's a force field like right here, like right this block. So it's automatically turned on when you're here. But if you step like next to the force field, the redstone signal will turn off and you will be able to walk through a specific force field from a mod. Just an idea. So yeah, pretty awesome if you ask me. So that's why I pretty much chose for the Draconic Evolution play detectors to show you guys, as it offers a lot of configurability in your worlds and for loads of different contraptions. So that is pretty much it for this video, guys. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed and found it very entertaining. If you'd like to see more of these little short block showcase videos, be sure to let me know down in the comment section below, because I always read all my comments. Be sure to check out my website too to stay up to date with my news, blogs and all that cool stuff like that, and of course all my social media. So thanks for watching, guys, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks!